Majority Whip Steve Scalise is here. Congressman, thanks for coming on this morning. You were in that meeting yesterday. How did it go?
Well, I thought it was good that the president said that he does want to take action, but I think what's most important is that the action we take actually solves the problem and not infringe upon the rights of law-abiding citizens who, by and large, are looking at all the failures of government from the FBI to local law enforcement and saying that's why they want guns to protect themselves if they don't have confidence that the other things that should have happened, that should have stopped this shooter, didn't happen because of breakdowns by people in government.
How far do you think this president is willing to go when it comes to changing gun laws in this country?
Well, again, I think President Trump wants to take action, and he is a man of action. That's what I like about him. But here you've got a legislative process where these are complicated issues, and some of these gun control measures have been tried before and failed, even when you had super majorities of Democrats in office. And there's reasons for that. It's not just groups like the NRA. It's the millions of people who are law-abiding citizens who want to be able to defend themselves. So let's actually close loopholes that exist. We passed a good bill out of the House that actually fixes real problems with the background check system while also increasing safety by allowing people with concealed carry permits to go to other states that have the same kind of permits, just like you move from state to state with a driver's license. That increases safety. So let's fix the problems.
And Congressman, that is exactly what you were touting in that meeting to the president yesterday when this exchange happened. Watch.
So I would hope that that's not immediately dismissed, because there is a lot of talk of just putting that on the side.
And just, I do think this. You know, I'm your biggest fan in the whole world. I think that maybe that bill will someday pass, but it should pass as a separate. If you're going to put concealed carry between states into this bill, we're talking about a whole new ballgame. And, you know, I'm with you, but let it be a separate bill. You'll never get this passed. If you add concealed carry to this, you'll never get it passed.
Well, there are other ideas that are being talked about that wouldn't pass the House.
I don't think, you know, again, you'll never get it passed. So we want to get something done.
That is a House-passed measure you were touting there, and the president seemed to shut that down.
Well, at least President Trump did say that he supports that, whether or not it's a standalone. I think it is important to note that that did pass the House. The Senate has yet to pass anything. They've brought up some of those ideas that were discussed yesterday. They've brought those bills up in the past and didn't get the necessary votes in the Senate. So let's see what the Senate can pass. And I do think this should be at least part of the discussion, because the discussion should be about increasing safety, fixing problems in a system that's broken at the federal and local level. And then let's work to make our schools safer. And there were some really good ideas that were thrown out that I think we can agree on. The Safe School Act, fixing problems in our mental health system and fixing problems with the background check system while focusing on other things that increase safety. There are some good ideas that are bipartisan we could get done, but there were some other ideas that were thrown out that actually do more to impede on the rights of law-abiding citizens. That's where I think we have to be careful.
There are some Democrats, some were in that meeting and some coming out of that meeting, who are talking about this president looking like he's siding more with Democrats on the issue of gun control and changing gun laws in this country than he is Republicans. Would you agree with that?
No, because in the end, President Trump is a supporter of the Second Amendment, and he also is somebody who wants to get things done. And that's why I think it's very important that it's not about just doing something. It's about doing the right thing that solves the problem. There could be action that's taken that could make things worse. And that's why I think we need to go look at the breakdowns that occurred, fix those problems, and then focus on things that increase safety. That's why I said at least have concealed carry reciprocity as one of the items on the table. Because if you look, by and large, the people that have concealed carry permits across this country are some of the safest gun users, and in fact, in many cases, help prevent crimes. That's what we want to focus on. And I do think the president was right in pointing out that so many of these mass shootings occur in gun-free zones because the shooter knows they're the only one with a gun and there's no one to confront them. I think that's something that needs to be looked at a lot closer.
This is something that's so close to your heart and your family's heart, obviously, Congressman, because if it weren't for a gun on that baseball field that day, you might not be here.
Yeah, the United States Capitol Police officers and the Alexandria police officers confronted the shooter and ultimately took him down and saved all of us. I wish that happened with the law enforcement officer that was on the scene with a gun in Parkland. For whatever reason, he hid instead of confronting the shooter. That needs to be addressed, and I think at the state level, they are addressing it. At the federal level, the FBI had Cruz on a silver platter saying he wanted to be a professional school shooter, and somewhere in that process, it slipped through the cracks. I think we ought to have hearings to find out who made the decisions to not pursue that case and hold people accountable.
It's devastating to learn that's what went on when that shooter was still active inside of that school. Congressman Steve Scalise, always good to see you. Thanks for being here this morning.
Great being with you. Thanks. Okay.